I'm Thomas, and I'm a sex researcher. A couple weeks ago, I did my first speaking engagement for Shit They Won't Tell You in Sex Ed at the Guys We Fest charity event in Brooklyn. So firstly, a big thank you to everyone that came out to the talk and all the great questions people had for me about breakups. Since then, I've been thinking about how I responded to one question in particular. Someone asked me how they can trust new people after having been hurt or cheated on by someone else. This is a very common question, and the response I gave included looking back on the prior relationship and thinking about what things you may have ignored, and then don't ignore them in the future relationship. I also stress how important it is that you learn to trust people in future relationships, because otherwise, you're only going to ruin them yourself. You can't have a good relationship without trust, which doesn't necessarily mean monogamy. There can be the same level of trust in an open relationship. So I agree with everything I said, but in thinking about it later, there's something else I wish I would have added. I think the key to learning to move on after being cheated on begins with having to increase the trust you have in yourself. And no, I don't mean trust that you won't cheat, but trust that if someone cheated on you, you would be able to get through it. It might not be pleasant, but you'd survive. For many of us, especially those that are afraid of being cheated on, the thought of being cheated on probably gives you anxiety. You can feel it gripping your stomach, and the best way that you know to get rid of that anxiety might be to investigate your partner, which could mean checking their phone, checking their emails, looking at text messages, even asking them repeatedly if they're cheating. This behavior of constantly checking for cheating is a form of safety seeking, meaning you look for signs of cheating or you ask your partner about it, you don't find those signs or your partner assures you that they're not cheating, and then your anxiety goes away. Next time you have anxiety, you go back to the safety seeking behavior because at the end of it, you know your anxiety will be gone. It's a form of reinforcement, but it doesn't solve the actual problem, which is your fear of being cheated on. Here's the hard truth about cheating. There's no guarantee your partner isn't cheating on you. There's also no guarantee that your next partner won't cheat, or every single partner that you have after that. But it's also possible that no one will ever cheat on you, or cheat on you again. Life is about the unknown, and we can't control others. However, we can control ourselves. And if you're someone that gets caught up in imagining you're getting cheated on and goes searching for evidence to feel better, you're only hurting yourself. Instead, question yourself and what beliefs you have about being cheated on. One way to do this is ask yourself, what would it mean if this person was cheating on me? Does it mean you're unlovable? That you're bad in bed? That you're ugly? That you're not enough as you are? The list could go on and be different for everyone. But is it rational? Probably not. Why does any one person, or any group of people for that matter, get to decide what your value is? When you notice that you're experiencing anxiety about if someone is cheating, talk to yourself about how if they are, it doesn't change your value. Allow yourself to think logically about what you'd do if they were cheating. Maybe you'd have to move out, get a job, be single, but are any of these things really the end of the world? Again, they might not be pleasant, but they aren't the end of the world. You need to build trust in yourself that if something bad did happen, you'd get through it. So if you struggle with trusting partners because you've been burnt, then you already know you can get through it because you have before. But if you haven't been burnt and you still struggle with it, then you need to know what might happen. But if it did, you'd find a way through. Having more trust in yourself should lead you to feel less anxiety about your relationship. This doesn't mean that feeling less anxiety will make it easier for your partner to cheat, but you having more anxiety definitely doesn't make it harder for them to cheat either. I wish I could tell you all that no one will ever cheat on you and you have nothing to worry about, but that's not reality. And the reality is, if someone cheated on you, it doesn't change your value as a person, and although it might be shitty for a while, you'd survive. Trust that you're strong enough to handle it as you would any other life experience that can be painful. I'll see you next time. Thanks for watching. I've got a lot of content in production and I don't want you to miss out. So go ahead and click that subscribe button. And in the meantime, check out one of these other videos. And don't forget to send me your questions about sex to thomastalksabout@gmail.com.